What's going on, guys? Coach Mandler here. Today I'm going to be sharing with you my thoughts on where exactly in your daily routine you should be plugging in your ab work so that you don't just get a set of ripped up six-pack abs, but also build a ton of core strength so that you can dominate each and every one of your lifts. Okay, normally I tell people to address a specific weak point in your daily routine at the very beginning of your workout. And we do that because typically that's when your body is fresh and able to make specific adaptations that you want it to make. But something like this, something like your abs and your core, if you're going to be working on that and pre-exhausting that in the very beginning of your workout, the residual effect of that is going to be lower levels of performance in your core lifts and all the other supplemental and accessory lifts that address the weak points. So to give you an idea of what I'm talking about here is, let's say you do like a 5 to 10 minutes intense ab routine right before you're doing your squat, your bench, or your deadlift. What's going to happen is that a lot of the strength that your body requires to kind of stabilize your spine during those big three core lifts is going to be kind of taken away from the fact that you pre-exhausted it with that ab routine. So what I tell people to do to get ripped abs, but also build a lot of strength in your core that doesn't take away from your core lifts, is to do your ab routine at the very tail end of your workouts as a finisher. Do this so that you can not have lowered levels of performance in your core lift, but also get the benefits of increasing the strength and stamina of your core muscles, so your abs, your obliques, and your lower back, your rectus spinae, so that you're getting the best of both worlds. And trust me, even if you didn't do any direct ab work or any direct core work, you're still getting a lot of strength and activation in your core by doing your core lifts, because there's a lot of stabilization that has to go on to really keep that weight secured and make sure that you're doing the lift properly. So what I would do in a nutshell is just, instead of doing it in the very beginning, like most of your weak point training or your specific weak points that you're trying to address or bring up, I would do it at the very tail end, okay? And to add to that, I'm going to share with you one real quick exercise that is one of my absolute favorites to really get a lot of strength and really etch out a tight, ripped up six pack, as well as obliques too. So stay tuned for that as well. All right, guys, one of my absolute favorite ways to get that tight, ripped up six pack and nice set of obliques is to do what's called just a hanging leg raise. I like these are far superior in my mind to doing any ab work on your back, just because it's more functional movement pattern. Alright, so what we're going to do, just grab, doesn't matter really your grip, I like just a shoulder width grip, and instead of swinging up, kipping like that, I want you to stay nice and tight, try to keep your spine completely perpendicular with the ground, come up, hold. If you want to engage more of the obliques, basically just tilt at that last second. Tilt. Tilt. Just like that. Great way to get that ripped up six pack and nice tight set of obliques. Hey guys, if you're really interested in getting that ripped up tight looking six pack that gets all the chicks wet, then you gotta pick up this free gift that I got for you in the top right of this video. 5 routines that are going to absolutely get you shredded. They're absolutely free, so pick that up. And if you haven't done so already, subscribe to this channel and let me know how I can better serve you into getting that better, badass body that looks good while kicking ass. Have a good one, guys. Manly. Out.